Paris officials are urging museum guards to be more vigilant following this week's $100 million art heist. Investigators are reviewing surveillance video that captured a masked intruder stealing five paintings Thursday from the Paris Museum of Modern Art. Some of the paintings include works by Picasso and Matisse. The museum's alarm system had been partially broken, though, since March 30th. Joining me live from London is Charles Hill, formerly of the Scotland Yard Art Squad. Charles, good morning.
Good morning.
I'm curious how, at least it seems, there's one person responsible for this, and how, if so, one man can pull something like this off.
It's certainly unusual. Usually you get, in Western Europe, gangs of thugs going around and either intimidating people or beating them up and crashing in and taking things and slashing them out of the frames. Mm. This guy was entirely different.
Do you think this, if it is just one person, does it have to be done with inside information?
I think without a shadow of a doubt, he had information that that alarm system was down. And as a consequence, he knew how to get into the place through a window, break a padlock. And he also knew he had time to go from one gallery to another collecting up these five pictures. And they're all very important ones, art historically. So he knew something about art as well.
Mm-hmm. So, and he did it, you think, with an appreciation for that which he was stealing? I mean, did he take better care of the artwork than other, as you described, thugs might have otherwise done it?
Yes, I think that the point you've just made is absolutely the right one. He took these things out of the frames carefully and then took the pictures away with him and left the frames intact. And as a consequence of that, you've got to think this is someone who's very unusual. He's not just on his own, but he cares about what he's doing. Mm. But what the purpose of him stealing these things is, I just don't know.
Yeah, right. And I'm curious how he had that much time to do this kind of an art heist. I mean, where were the guards? Where was the video, you know, all of it, the video surveillance?
Well, I think the mayor of Paris is asking the same questions that you are and that have occurred to all of us. What exactly were the guards doing? What were they told to do? Why couldn't they see what we've seen subsequently on the video, or at least somebody's seen subsequently on the video, of this lone individual? There are a lot of questions to be answered, and I think people are going to be struggling to find those answers.
Well, and Charles, as you know, there'll be plenty out in the art world on the lookout for Picassos and Matisse's in particular. So what can a guy do with these paintings? I mean, does he privately sell them to someone who knows they're stolen?
That is the least likely thing to happen.
Huh.
And the next least likely thing is that the mayor of Paris is going to pay a ransom for them. So if you just dismiss out of your mind this private collector who lives in some, you know, Dr. No's subterranean fortress, or you know, going for a reward from the mayor of Paris, then there must be a purpose for stealing these, and just how he's going to use them or negotiate with them, well, you know, we're going to find out, I think.
Yeah, but Charles, is it safe to say that there's no way he's just going to go and knock on, you know, Christie's door and say, hey, can you sell these for me? I mean, you know, come on.
There's absolutely no market at all for these sorts of paintings, not a legitimate market, and the black market for stolen art is not thriving either, so he has no market.
This is a fascinating story. Do you have any idea how this is going to end up? I mean, is there a chance these will be recovered, or will we never see the likes of them again? How do you see this playing out?
Well, by and large, the more valuable a work of art is, the more likely it is to be recovered. Let's not, you know, we don't want to be held to that, but it is generally true that these five paintings certainly are of such quality that the minute they came to the surface anywhere, people would be ringing the police and, you know, claiming some kind of reward. But the simple fact is that these five pictures, I'm sure, are going to turn up. When, I don't know, but they will turn up.
Hmm. Okay. Charles Hill, pleasure speaking with you there, formerly of Scotland Yard. Thank you.
You're welcome.